Okay, so good afternoon, students. So welcome to Purposive Communication subject again. And today we're going to discuss a very important matter which will deal and help you guys to be effective in communication. Okay, so communication is very important, no? As we have discussed prior to the prior week, because when we say communication, that is our way to adapt the culture, and at the same time, through the help of communication, we could identify or help ourselves to express our feelings, to say what we want to say, and to explore the community with the help of communication. So today, class, we are going to discuss an important matter, which is about the public speaking. Okay, so back when I have given you a task, which is to give me your expectation to my subject, and one of the expectation is for you guys to be effective in communication, most especially to the crowd. Okay, kasi po, alam kong hindi lang ako, hindi lang ang isa sa inyo, kundi karamihan sa atin, we are afraid to talk to people. We are afraid of recitation, of presentation, kasi nahihiya tayo. Tama ba? Okay? But I have to say this, guys, that public speaking, communication, expressing yourself is part of life. Tama po? Ibig sabihin, hindi siya bastang gusto lang ng bawat individual na magsabi ka ng nararamdaman mo. O kaya naman, mag-share ka ng gusto mong sabihin, o mag-recite ka, o mag-present ka. But it is a must. Pag sinabi po nating must, kailangan mo siyang gawin, whether you like it or not. Okay? So, most especially for you guys, entrepreneur students, okay? And we have criminology students po. Your future, okay? Your future career would require you to be effective in communication, effective in communicating, okay? So, ma'am, what do you mean by public speaking? So, when we say public, okay, himay-himayin muna natin yung two terminologies na meron po dyan. When we say public, that is composed of one individual, one listener, one audience, okay? So, when we say public, it is composed of two persons, maybe, or more than that, that is listening to you, applauding into you, agreeing with what you are saying, and at the same time, the purpose of public speaking or the purpose of the public in speaking whenever you are saying something is that specific people will identify your weakness and your strength in speaking and share your ideas, okay? And when you say speaking is the use or yes, the use of our mouth, okay, the use of our voice, okay, to express everything that we want to say corresponding to the specific topic that we are owed to, okay, so that is public speaking, okay, so let's define more. So when we say public speaking, this is a presentation that's given live before the audience. Public speeches can cover a wide variety of different topics. The goal of the speech may be to educate, entertain, or influence the listeners. Often, visual aids in the form of an electronic slideshow are used to supplement the speech and make it more interesting to the listeners. Okay, so one thing that you should remind of yourself is this formula. Okay, we have live presentation plus the audience. I repeat, public speaking is live presentation plus the audience. So, live presentation plus audience is equals to public speaking. So, mama na pong ibig sabihin nyo. When we say public speaking po, that is presented live. So, when we say live, that is not recorded, that is not, that is practiced, yes, that is in the form of a stage, in the form of a crowd. Alam naman natin yun, di ba? Whenever we go back to our high school life, si valedictorian ay nagkakaroon or nagbibigay ng speech sa atin. So, that is an example of public speaking. So, yung isang bagay na mapapansin natin sa public speaking, it is presented live. Hindi po siya recorded or nasa TV. Hindi po siya mapapanood lang natin sa convenience natin, kundi pag sinabi po natin public speaking, whether we like it or not, you have to listen because you are one of the audience. And when we say audience, okay, so yan yung sinasabi natin public kanina. Okay po. So yung public or yung audience po na tinatawag natin, siya po yung pinatutungkulan, okay, or kaya naman po ang reason bakit po may public speaking, o kaya naman po si audience, siya naman po ang dahilan bakit po merong presentation or live presentation na nagaganap. Again, when we say public speaking, that is live presentation plus audience plus public speaking. So, bakit po natin ginawa yung formula na yon? Kasi po, meron tayong tinatawag na online presentation. Diba? Itong ginagawa ni ma'am, online presentation to. Pag si ma'am nagturo sa harap, hindi nasa classroom setup tayo, that is a public speaking. Pero po, kapag si ma'am, ito yung ginagawa ko, this is an online presentation. Kahit na po marami tayong nakikinig, okay, hindi po siya matatawag na public speaking because this is not live. This is not done through the help of a platform, but rather this is recorded. Understood? So public speeches can cover a wide variety of different topics. The goal of the speech may be to educate. Yes, that is one of the function of public speaking, to educate people. Okay po. For example, in a classroom setup, that is an example. Okay po. Entertain. Okay po. So kung manunood tayo ng mga stage plays, okay? So that is a combination of education and entertainment. Okay? Or influence the listeners. So meron pong mga public speakers, meron pong mga taong nagsasalita in the front of many people to influence, okay? Often visual aids in the form of an electronic slideshow are used to supplement the speech and make it more interesting to the listeners. So some of the public speaker, they use pictures, okay? Diba? Na piniplay po sa isang monitor, biniplay para po ma-visualize lalo ng mga audience kung ano po yung sinasabi or gustong i-employ sabihin po ni public speaker. Okay, intindihan natin. So, public speaking po, that is very important in the form or in the area of business, education, okay? And actually this is very important in the area of every people, diba? Kasi for example, in the area of business, you could not promote or the audience, the consumer, the customers would not approve the kind of product that you have if you're not confident to present it. So, public speaking is good for promotion. Tama po? Kaya po tayo may tinatawag na commercials. Pag pumasok ka sa mga mall, sa mga sa department store, or kaya naman sa supermarket, meron tayong mga nakikita na nagpapa-pre-taste, tapos nagsasalita sila, nagpapaliwanag kung anong lasa, paano gamitin yung product nila. That is an example of public speaking in the form of businesses. Because through the help of public speaking or public speech, that would help that person or the business to explore or to implore what kind of products you have, and that helps the consumers to buy more of your products. Okay? So often visual aids, ayan, so in the form of an electronic slideshow, nabanggit ko na kanina. Okay? So sa area naman po ng education, public speeches is very important also because, di ba nga, tulad ng sinabi ko kanina, we have presentation. Di ba po, meron po tayong presentation sa harap that we are allowed or we have to explore the learnings to our students or to our classmates. Okay? So that is very important. Maintindihan natin. Okay? And also in education, with the help of public speaking, okay? Kasi po meron tayong tinatawag na oral presentation eh. Hindi po lahat ay written. Hindi po matetest ang kakayahan ng bata kung panay written exam lang po natin. Okay? So, through the help of public speaking, kami as a teacher, we could identify kaano kayo natuto. Tama po? Okay. So, we also have actually lahat. Okay? In the area of entertainment, kaya po tayo na-entertain kasi po maraming tao na magaling magsalita, magaling magpatawa. Okay? And that is public speaking. Okay po. So let's continue. So let's give or have a brief history of public speaking. So there is a good chance that there's been public speaking in one form or another, as long as there have been people. But most academics and other involved with public speaking includes those at the public speaking project, trace the origins of modern public speaking back to the ancient Greece and Rome. Those societies didn't have any electronic conveniences we've got today to help with public speaking, but they have a need for a public speaking and develop public speaking methods that there are still studied today. Okay, so kailan pong pagkakataon or back in our centuries, when was the time that this public speaking was used? Okay, so yun po ay sa panahon ng ancient Greece and Rome. So ma'am, sobrang tagal na po nun. Yes, absolutely right. Okay, kasi bakit sabi dito those societies, this one, wait a minute. Those societies didn't have any ancient electronic convenience. So be reminded of that. The reason why public speaking was being promoted that moment is that there is no electronic conveniences. When we say electronic conveniences, in short, hindi pa po uso si technology. Okay? So wala pa pong chat. Hindi pa po na-form si Facebook, si Instagram, na kung saan pwede po tayo makapag-communicate at sabihin or iparamdam sa ibang tao yung support natin. Okay? So, in the time of Greece and Rome, okay? So, that moment, wala pa po silang electronic devices and able for them to inform other people to the part of their community of what is happening now, what are the news, what are we going to do in the next days, their culture, okay? So, public speaking is the very best way for them to be informed. Tama po? Okay, basta lagi natin tatandaan, back in the history, there is no electronic conveniences in the time of Greece and Rome. That's why they use public speaking to promote unity, to promote support, and to lift up the spirit of every of their members. Okay, so that is the short background or history of the public speaking. So let us proceed. So what are the importance of public speaking? So number one, improve confidence. One way for you to improve your confidence is that you should or you must try to pursue or to make ways on how could you be a better influencer or to be a better public speaker. So, ma'am, record po ba talaga ang marunong ka magsalita? Yes, mga anak. Number one, hindi mo po may pagtatanggol ang sarili mo if you're timid. If you conserve yourself with the ideas that you have and then you don't share it. Tama po? Okay? So, ngayon, no, kapag hindi ka nagsalita, kawawa ka. And that is true. Tama po? Hindi po natin kung hindi tayo mapapakinggan ng ibang tao and we have the right motive of saying that. We have the right thing. We have the right reasons to say that. And then you didn't say it at all. Ikakapahamak siya. Hindi lang natin, kundi ng maraming tao. Tama po? Okay? But gossip, chismis na tinatawag, is different from public speaking. Take note of that. Okay? So make sure that you use public speaking in a good way. Make sure you use public speaking to morally upright people, to promote unity, to promote goodness, to promote right motive and right conduct to other people. Naintindihan natin? Okay, so as much as possible, if you have nothing to say on the social media na maganda, then don't say it at all. Tama? If you have nothing to say against an issue na hindi naman talaga natin alam, don't say it at all because it is a waste of time. Hindi ma-judge ng tao yung taong dinidescribe natin, but rather we are criticized by that type of communication or type of things that we are doing. Why? Kasi po, that is your account, that is your post, So that's why the person that has been described is not that specific person, but you who posted it. Tama po? So make sure you use wisely your confidence, you use wisely the public speaking. Okay? So I hope you have understood that. Okay? So it improves public speaking, or it improves confidence din po yung public speaking. Kasi po, di ba, pag natutukunta mo yun sa maraming tao, matututunan mo na din na sa mga susunod na araw, mas marunong ka na mag-share ng natutunan mo or ng gusto mong sabihin. Okay? So, ganun po yun. Next po, better research skills. Sabi ko nga kanina, the reason why you do public speaking or public speeches is that you are saying valid ideas or valid informations. So, pag sinabi po natin valid, that is true, that is just, that is not just according to your opinion, but rather that is a factual information that you're searching or that you are saying. So, how could we identify or how could we give good, wise information through research skills that we have? Okay po, naintindihan natin. In short, kapag po tayo gagawa ng public speaking or public speech, magsesearch po tayo ng mga ideas na reliable. Kasi mamaya si audience na may narinig siya sa'yo na hindi totoo, this is a criticism on you. And at the same time, hindi po pwede na magsabi po tayo ng mga bagay na hindi totoo sa harapan ng maraming tao, because that is a shame for us. That is, that could cause trouble, that could cause tension to your audience. Number three, stronger deductive skills. Pag sinabi po natin deductive, that is reasoning. Make sure that your reasoning is correct. Okay? So, make sure corresponding po siya sa number two. Okay po. So, for example, you do a speech about this COVID. Okay po. So, nag-promote ka or yung public speech na ginawa mo is for you to encourage people. What are your reasons why you're encouraging these people in the first place? So, you have to conduct stronger deductive skills. So, when you implore, when you share to these people, ilan na yung may COVID sa pagkakataong ito, that should require research skills, a wide research skills, and at the same time, your reasoning should be good. Okay po. So, for example din po, in business, bakit mo kailangan bilhin tong product na to? Okay? So, papasok po siya sa stronger deductive skills. Kailangan po, yung idea na ini-implore mo, kailangan po, yung pinaka reason bakit mo siya binibenta is tama. Okay? At pag nabinili ni customer yung specific products natin, is malalaman or ma-identify nila na tama po yung sinasabi natin nung nag-promote tayo. Number four, ability to advocate causes. One of the functions of public speaking or the importance of public speaking is that it advocate for causes. Okay? We do not public speech, we do not talk without any reasons. Okay? Kaya kung mapapansin natin, whenever they're trembling, there are problems against our government, against, for example, sa isang company, meron po nagra-rally na tinatawag. Okay? Because yung rally, they say that it is a way to share to them or to speak in behalf of the whole company, of the whole country, of what the count or what the specific community felt or their situation. Okay, so it advocate causes. We make sure na after we do public speaking, public speech, it would result into better community, into better results po. Okay, so let's make sure na ang content ng bawat public speaking or public speeches natin ay correct and at the same time valid and reliable for the people to trust us more in the coming days. Okay po, so that is the importance of public speaking. Take note of that. Okay, so how to become better at public speaking? The truth is that public speaking is a skill. It can be learned. Okay, so si Ma'am Sheena, ako, hindi po talaga, I'm not very good in public speaking or in talking to many people. Kung babalikan niyo po ako nung elementary at high school. Tama? Okay? So, ibig sabihin po nun, paano po tayo gumaling? Paano po tayo natutong magsalita ng hindi nahihiya nang hindi natatakot. That is through experiences. That is through some ways, okay? Sa pag-aaral, sa pag pagre-research, okay? Paghahanap ng inspirasyon sa pagsasalita. Ganun po 'yon. Hindi po siya basta-bastang natututunan. But at the same time, hindi naman po siya mahirap matutunan din, okay? So, ibig sabihin lang po noon, huwag po tayong mahirapan or huwag po tayong ma-pressure na, ma'am, nahihirapan ako para hindi ko to kaya. Ganyan din yung sinabi ko nung bata ako. Okay? So, we just have to be patient with ourselves because communication is a process. Tama? Napag-aralan natin yan. Communication is developmental. So, that's the reason why if we could notice back when we are in our elementary, we have mga judgment pa tayo, mga ganun, okay? And then, nung high school, medyo okay na, and then, naging professional na tayo magsalita. Nung college, lalong-lalo na, kapag graduate na kayo. So, that is a process. Just be patient with yourself. While some people may have more natural speaking ability than others, yes, that is a natural ability. There are some, ha, na kung saan pinanganak sila, na they have pleasing voice and charismatic. So, kung mapapansin natin kapag sila nagsasalita, alam mo yun, nakakatch na yung attention mo. Yung nakakatch na yung tenga mo na talagang makikinig ka. Tama po? Okay. So, may mga ganong uri ng tao and they are blessed. Pero ulitin ko, if you are not that way, be patient with yourself because that is a process. Okay? So, anyone who can speak can learn to be a better public speaking, to be a public speaker, than they are right now. It just takes some know-how and some effort. So, ibig sabihin po, through the help of learning, through the help of the communication, through the help of some effort, through the help of some curiosities, we could learn or we could be better in public speaking. Okay? So, I hope you understand that. Ang ibig sabihin lang po nun, kapag gusto po natin matutunan na maging better na public speaker, we have to take some effort. Wala po tayong magigain kung hindi po tayo mag-aaral. Wala po tayong magigain kung hindi po natin nanaisin na matuto. Tama po? Okay. So for you guys to be better in public speaking or for you, it might help you guys to identify what are your weaknesses and strengths and to be improved. Okay po. So, we have 10 tips for public speaking. Number one, nervousness is normal, practice and prepare. Okay po. So, that wet hands, okay? So, yung pangangatal natin, yung pag nagsasalita tayo is pakaramdam natin, nasusuka tayo, natatayo, na hindi natin maramdaman. That is normal, I tell you. Even the spokesperson of our country, the spokesperson of the Philippines, the spokesperson of our president, nervousness is normal. Don't take it as it's just normal to yourself. It's normal to everyone. Okay? So, actually, meron tayong nervousness na tinatawag sa sarili natin, psychological, na nag-attract sa atin or nag-dictate sa atin to do better, and that is the adrenaline rush. So, yung adrenaline rush natin, it would give us the tendency or the feelings or the guts to do your best. Okay po? So, mga anak, whenever we do, parang ayoko na ituloy ito, diba? Pag may pinagawa si mom na activity, just remember your motive. Bakit ko ba ito ginagawa in the first place? Tama po? Because you will end up doing well. Okay, so what are the best way for us to overcome nervousness? Number one, practice. Okay, practice makes perfect. Okay, and there is perfection when you do practicing. Okay po. And prepare. Okay, so paano pa tayo magpa-practice, magpe-prepare? Pwede kayong mag-video sa harapan ng iyong cellphone. O kaya naman po, pwede po tayong magsulat ng script, magsaulado ng script, mag-perform sa harap ng salamin, mag-perform sa harap ng kaibigan natin para i-critic tayo. Okay? So, just practice, and prepare. Number two, know your audience, your speech is about them, not about you. Always remember that one of the most important factor in public speaking is the audience. make sure po na kapag po tayo magdudo or gagawa ng public speaking, kino-consider po natin yung uri ng audience na meron tayo. So, hindi po tayo pwede mag-talk ng about ng innovation, entrepreneurship, okay? Criminology, kung ang kausap natin mga elementary students. Okay? Pakabatuhin lang tayo ng kamatis niya. Naintindihan natin. So, make sure po na alam po natin yung audience na kakausapin natin. Okay po? So, most especially sa pagkakataong ito, ang lagi lang naman nating mga kausap is mga classmates natin. So, naibabagay natin yung mga sasabihin natin. So, why do we need to know the audience? The type of audience that we have? Para po alam po natin yung level of information na sasabihin natin, the choices of words, and the way how would we deliver our speech. Number three, organize your materials in the most effective manner to attain your purpose. So when we say organizing your materials, so make sure that the part of the script that you have should be in order. We have the introduction, we have the content. Okay, kanina po, nabanggit natin na dapat may stronger deductive skill tayo. So, yung with the help of stronger deductive skill or reasoning, that should be organized also in our thoughts. So, ibig sabihin po, yung reasoning natin, dapat po yan ay general to specific. Okay, so sa introduction, we should say or we would say to other people, what are the content of the speech that we have? And then in specific content, we could identify there what are the minor reasons, who are your targets, and at the same time, why are you doing that in the first place? Okay po. So, for example, nagkaroon tayo ng cooking show. Okay? So, sa introduction, i-welcome natin yung mga audience natin, and then sa content, ay sa introduction din po, isasabihin natin po yung kung ano yung dulutuin natin, and then po doon sa specific part ng content natin, din po natin sabihin yung ingredients, yung ways kung paano magluto, etc. Okay. And then we should end with an encouragement to our audience. Next, number four, watch for feedbacks and adapt it. So, when you are doing public speaking and when you observe your audience is not listening, or kaya naman, mapapansin natin kapag na ang audience natin hindi nyo intindihan tayo. Number one, hindi yun kumikibo. Number two, lumiliit yung mata. Parang sumisingkit na. Ano sabi niya? Ganun yun nasa isip niya. Number two, kapag pakamot-kamot yun sa ulo or hiccup ng hiccup, hindi po yan interesado sa gagawin natin, sa ginagawa natin or sa pinoportray natin kapag nagre-report tayo, kapag nagpe-present. So, ano pong gagawin natin kapag ganun, ma'am? Number one, catch their attention. You could call their attention. Do they have any question? Do they have any clarification? Or kaya naman po, ulitin mo yung part na sa tingin mo hindi nila naiintindihan. Okay? And eye-to-eye contact to your audience is very important, mga anak. Why? Because that would implore to them that you are really talking to them personally. Okay? So watch for the feedback. Number five, let your personality come through. Do not be a talking head. When we say talking head, para kang ano, spokesperson na nagbabasa lang ng letter ng kung sino man. So, ibig sabihin, when you are talking or delivering a speech, when you are delivering public speaking, make sure po na you are talking in behalf of yourself. Naintindihan natin? So, if you are talking about inspirational thoughts, like for example, ang pinag-uusapan po is about sa achievements mo, okay? So, make it very personal to the point of sharing your thoughts, sharing your experiences for them to see na inspiring ka. For you to meet your goal, which is to encourage other people. Naintindihan natin. Okay? So, that is a very important factor that we should consider in public speaking. Let your personality speak. Let your personality come through. Number six, use humor. Tell stories and use effective language. Okay? So, use humor because humor is number one, is the number one most catchy way of talking to people. Okay? So, when we say humor, we use jokes. Okay? Pero wag naman to the point na jokes lang yung maalala sa atin ng audience natin. Hindi niyan po natin. Tell stories. Okay? So, sabi ko nga kanina, If you are speaking about love life, then tell something about your stories. Paano ka naka-move on? Paano mo siya natagpuan? Mga ganun. Pero sabi nga sa number five, that your personality comes through. You could not speak of what you don't have. So ibig sabihin lang po nun, you could not talk about love life if you don't have one. Okay? So, number five and six are connected. Okay po. So, use effective language. Intindihan natin? So, that's very important. Number seven, don't read unless you have to work from an outline. Okay? So, ang purpose po ng script, mga anak, listen to this, ha? Ang purpose po ng script is para sa uladuhin or sa uluhin. Okay po? At ang purpose po ni outline is para po maging guide natin kapag po tayo ay tatayo na sa harap. Okay? So, usually si outline po naka-bullet lang, tapos per term lang siya or kaya phrase po. Pero po si script, yung talagang ilang page ng sasabihin mo is nandun. Do not read. Kasi kung babasahan mo lang naman ang mga audience mo, edi sana namigay ka na lang ng photocopy. Tama po? Si ma'am personally, kapag tayo face-to-face ngayon, ayaw na ayaw ko po nang nagre-report sa harap. Tapos, babasahin lang yun nasa band paper or nandun sa presentation. That is very bad idea. Okay? Kasi kung ganun lang naman, kami na lang magbasa. Tama po? So, don't read. Okay po? So, work in an outline. Magdala kayo ng isang, for example, index card sa harap. Sige po, pwede po tayo tumingin dyan kapag may nakalimutan tayo. But don't read. Okay po? Baka layasan tayo ng mga audience natin. Next, use audiovisual aids wisely. So when we say audiovisual, we could have or we could use background song, background music, okay? Para po mas mainggan yung makinig yung mga audience natin. And make sure po na si audio natin, yung type ng audio natin is nababagay po dun sa story na sinasabi natin, ha? Okay. So, for example, you're telling about it's a graduation speech. Tapos, ang tunugan mo, ang sound mo is ang pang-party. Okay? So, it would distract our audiences. And at the same time, another thing about audiovisual aids, make sure po na ang ginagamit nating visual aids ay hindi po masyadong colorful. To the point po na hindi na po sa atin ang attention ng mga nanonood. Okay? Hindi po na po sa atin ang attention ng, sa mga sinasabi natin, yung attention ng nakikinig, kundi nandun na lang sa visual aids natin. I remember, no, back when I was in high college, meron akong classmate na nag-present, tapos sa PowerPoint presentation, may mga lumilipad na ibon, may Hello Kitty, diba, ang sakit sa mata? Or, maganda naman, pero hindi mo na naiintindihan yung sinabi niya sa sobrang ganda nung audiovisual aids niya. Okay? So, ganun din po sa public speaking. If you're talking about your mother, then just show a picture of your mother. Okay? So, wag po natin pahirapan ang isa't isa ang sarili natin. Rather, use it very simple yet attractive. Okay? Next. Number eight, use your voice and hands effectively. Omit nervous gestures. So, one thing that we should be reminded or one thing that we should remind ourselves, gamitin natin, make sure that our voice is audible and at the same time, hindi po magalaw si kamay. That our hands should correspond or our hands should be effective in a way that it explore, it says, or it shows the things that we are explaining. Omit nervous gestures, meron tayong mga mannerism na ginago. Minsan, nagkakamot ng ulo, nagkakamot ng ilong. Ako personally, yun yung struggle ko eh. Yun yung mannerism ko. Kasi nagpapawis yung ilong ko pag sobra akong nape-pressure. Ganun. Okay, meron namang mga lalaki na pinapasok yung kamay nila sa bulsa. Okay, or whatever you have. Just stand straight there. Put your hands on the both side. Okay, or kaya naman kung may hand gestures tayo, maglalakad tayo, then do so. Basta wag naman yun nakaka-distract. Okay po? And lastly, grab attentions at the beginning and close with a dynamic end. So, when we say that, number one, use an introduction that would make your reader, that would make your audience watch you until the end. Okay po? So, that's very important that you should use introduction a very well introduction and close with a dynamic end. So when we say close with a dynamic end, if your goal is to encourage them, then motivate them. Okay? So ganun po yung gagawin natin sa end ng talk natin. Make sure po na kung ano po yung pinaka-goal natin at the end of our discussion, at the end of our public speaking or speech, make sure po na nabigyan po natin sila ng bagay na matututunan, na natutunan nila doon sa sinabi natin. In short, huwag niyong hayaan na natapos yung speech niyo nang walang nakuha or napala sa inyo yung audience niyo. Okay? So that is very important. And lastly, paulit-ulit ko kayong i-remind, be patient with yourself, because through the help of practicing, through the help of process or experience, we could be more effective. Hindi lamang po sa area ng public speaking, kundi sa lahat ng area ng buhay natin. Just be patient with yourself. Do not be in hurry. Okay? And practice. Okay po. Hindi po natin masisisi si audience. Hindi po natin masisisi yung mga nakikinig sa atin kung hindi po tayo nag-aral at nag-practice ng mga dapat natin sabihin or gawin. Okay? So I hope you understand something today. I hope you've learned things, great things today, because this is a very important part of your life, of your journey, and your career. Okay? And last pa rin na gusto kong i-share, hindi po required ang magaling ka mag-English. As long as you are understood by everyone, the person that you are talking to, that is enough. Okay? Hindi niyo po kailangan maging magaling sa accent, sa pag-deliver, kundi ulitin ko, as long as you are understood, that is okay. Okay po, huwag po natin masyadong pinipressure ang mga sarili natin. Kasi dito sa buhay natin, ang important lang po is maintindihan tayo. Maintindihan, maunawaan, para po hindi tayo nami-misinterpret. Understood? Okay, so thank you so much everyone. God bless. And I will send this to our group chat, your activity. Thank you so much. God bless. Goodbye.